All right, what's up, everybody? Yeah, welcome back to the very nostalgic return of this game we finished not even a month ago. And yes, pumpkin. Because I realized, wait, we replaced the earth with a pumpkin in that one thumbnail. So I'm going to replace the earth with a pumpkin in the intro. It's only fair. What an intro. Glad you enjoyed it, 3 AM. It cost $10, but it was worth it. Scream King, Freak Eclipse, Tay, how's everybody doing? Welcome to the filler arc of Dying Light. Because that's what we're here to do today. I made sure to grab the Hellraid expansion. Apparently I didn't have it already, so I grabbed that this morning. You're doing good? I'm doing fine. Yeah, we needed a perfect filler game to tide us over until Pokemon comes out, so why not take part in a literal, actual filler arc? Just the perfect non-canon adventure here. I can't stick around today, but if there's a live stream Saturday, then you'll try to be there for that. There will not be a live stream Saturday because turns out I got scheduled for work that day for orientation. So we will be streaming on Friday though, in Friday afternoon. So keep notifications on for that one. Now, of course, last we left off, Kyle Crane canonically became a mutant super zombie and was indoctrinated by the Gadoid leadership to use as a Darth Vader figure of sorts. Well, afternoon. It'll be night by the time we're done, but and yeah, time zones. Now, my question is, how do we get back to the tower? Like, the entire time we were playing this DLC, we never left the countryside. So I don't remember how to get out of here. Oh no, that's bad. How did we even get in here? I don't remember anymore. It hasn't been that long, but I still don't recall. Yeah, the DLC, it does take you to a completely different map, but to get to the map, we have to go back to the main map in Haran. And then in the tower, there's like an arcade machine that we use. Give me a sec. Maybe I can Google it. Let's see. Oh. Okay. Fair enough. I know what to do now. Also, is the side chat not working? Dagnabbit. Okay. Our plan is simple. We quit, hit play instead of continue. And then save the campaign. That's what we do. When we last left off, it was March 11th, apparently. Wait, that can't be right. Oh no, the it's in every other part of the world's way of telling time. That means November 3rd, today. Okay, fair enough. I was like, wait a second, that doesn't sound right. Twitch chat isn't going through. Oh, everything's broken then. Side chat's not working. Oh, no wonder the side chat isn't working. It must just be Restreamio being dumb. Yeah, that's probably it. Hey, so early, you made it on time. Yeah, the new follow, new subscriber, new donation screens don't work. Those never work. Only the new subscriber one would, works normally. Well. To be fair, not everything is not working. The game is working. I'll take that. Ah, pardon me, madam. Okay, it's sort of working. There's a little bit of a lagginess, but I'm sure it'll settle into itself pretty fast here. See, we're already doing fine. Subscribe 100 more times. Oh, your sister has a fever. It may just be a regular cold, but even if it was, I'm pretty sure restrictions have loosened a lot. Yeah, by this point, Depends on what she would need to do. Like, they might not want her, like, going into work or something, but that's about it. Okay, so I know for a fact, Jack, that the tower is where we go to do the Hellraid stuff. We have not been in Haran in a long time, but Crate Medi a DW. I don't know what that is. See, look, it says go to Hellraid right there. Good. See, that's our mission right there. It knows what we want to do. Boyfriend's been sick for the past 2 weeks. Yikes. Whoa! Been a while since that's happened. So, now, despite the fact that this is still a non-canon filler arc, it takes place before the following. It still didn't happen, but it chronologically is beforehand. Stream sponsored by your boy, Raid Shadow Legends. If only. Hellraid Shadow Legends. That's the voice I'm going to use if I do get sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. Oh, the lack of sound. Here, I'll fix that. I forgot to turn the desktop audio back up. My bad. At least I figured it out before we started doing anything important. It's been gone the whole time. Because reasons. Well, it's because I had to turn the desktop audio down for the Star Wars intro. That's why. Spend an extra 250 than you're planning to replace the CPU. Dang, you couldn't even get like a refund on that. Unfortunate. You know what really still astounds me to this day? Is that there are no mods that add lightsabers to this game. Seriously. Like, I know I already determined that during the original run, but...
You're the one who volunteered.
I killed him.
Charged. Something I can do for you?
I believe I can provide some context.
I can provide you with the history of Ryze. You see, he was a former Jedi Master in Pongkeln.
So take it as hearsay if you want.
I don't know what this is.
But it involves his brother, Hassan.
I know about Hassan.
You mean Pog?
And Ryze blames the GRE?
He's right to. Hassan was confined to our wheel.
I've heard this story.
He was the only person in the world Ryze cared about. Hassan acted as a tempering influence on his brother. Where Ryze wanted to go to war, Hassan convinced him to seek peace.
Interesting.
And when the outbreak happened, Ryze demanded that the GRE evacuate Hassan first.
Ah, one of those UV disinfecting lamps.
There was political infighting.
I've heard those can work, right?
Because of the ministry, the GRE dragged their feet.
And the ministry? What the heck is that?
The GRE could have removed him from harm's way immediately. They elected not to. And now
I find that hard to believe.
Lost his moral compass.
He already lost it, man. That's a lie.
On the populace of Haran.
So Ryze's beef with the GRE, you're saying he's justified?
I do not excuse him. He's a vicious gangster. A blight on this city. I merely wanted to help
the
you.
The air after that smells weird.
You will surely face.
Well, understood.
Strange.
Thanks.
The smell of dead bacteria. Now here's the eponymous Polybius cabinet, or Hellraid, as it were. Insert soul. Okay, those are skulls. Out of the corner of my eye, they looked like alien heads. All right, Kyle Crane walks up, looks at it dramatically as it begins to glow, and then boom, his soul gets sucked right in. It's the beginning of Cheetah Men, where an arm reaches out and pulls him inside. Promises of riches led you to the Forgotten Baal's Temple! What? They could have picked anybody, and they had to say Baal, didn't they? We haven't talked about that character in a while. Okay. Well, apparently Baal had a temple here. We're roping this into Pokemon lore now? Mana eats us inside. Yeah, just like Dark Souls 1. Mm-hmm. The poem you have to learn has a Baal reference. Huh. Welcome to Hellraid. How kind. This is the beginning of Hellraid's story mode. Venture into the depths of the Baal Temple. I didn't expect that. To uncover its secrets, to make your way back into the real world. Mm-hmm. Something seems to be brewing under this hell's surface. This hell's, yes. There's an end there. Unlocks raid mode. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Something about idols being broken in his temple, which is fitting since he's dead. Yeah. The Foul Blade. Are we still a ninja? For now, anyway. I want to get some knight armor. Rusty shivs. Dude, what happened to you? Someone took your frickin' leg. I'm sorry, bro. You didn't deserve that. Hold F to fast travel. Oh, to Brecken's Tower. It's like, we must finish story mode in order to be free and go to the real world. Or just hit these posters, I guess. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Baal isn't an actual god people have, worshipped historically. Nope, down we go. Man, it took everything I had, including my healing packs. Can I still do my drop kicks? Yes. Then we're good.
I feel your presence.
Lucius. I know that game.
Looking for treasure? Many have tried.
I'm not looking for treasure. I'm just trying to get the heck out of here. But, you know, it's a game. I get it. This looks like the... like that library prison in Dark Souls. There's a lot of Dark Souls happening here. Okay, now in the lore of this non-canon filler arc, is it just that he got warped back in time? Just to the events of Dark Souls 1? Is that what's happening here? An event in our lore that we haven't seen yet? But we know has happened. Oh no, zombies! It's not like we haven't dealt with these guys before. Yeah! I got 12 something. And 13 something. Acidic flask. That doesn't sound very medieval. What's happening? Deactivating shrines. To break the seal of hell on doors, you must deactivate all shrines. Yep. I can do that. Ah, hey, big guy. You're just a reskin of that regular big guy. Maybe? You're just the regular girl model. Mm-hmm. Grim Scepter, what the heck is that? This, apparently. Man, this thing is tough. And the sound effects are very satisfying. If I were to do the Dark Souls Pokeball mod playthrough, will I do it as a stream series or a recorded series? I would like to do it as a stream series, ideally. But, if it comes down to it at some point where that can't happen, then I would be willing to do it as a recorded series. But it's like, if you wanted to do it chronologically, it would take a while to get there. But it would be the most fun if I streamed it. Limb cutter. It's an axe. I mean, chronologically... like, if you wanted to make that the new canon... Dark Souls 3 playthrough, then Dark Souls 1, 2, and Bloodborne take place before that. But we don't necessarily have to do it in order. I mean, we've already screwed that up by doing Elden Ring, I guess. Maybe even longer than Sekiro? I mean, I'm pretty familiar with Dark Souls 3. When I first streamed it in 2017, I beat it in 13 streams back then. I could probably do it even faster now. Although that was without the Pokemon mod, I don't know if that would speed me up or slow me down. The pedestal with the first Clavis Stone. Oh, okay. Yeah, that is the question. Will Pokemon make it harder? I played it a bit before, but that was a while ago. I don't remember if I would consider that an easier run or a more difficult one. Ow. Did someone shoot a freaking arrow at me? Oh, jeez. And fighting skeletons in this game feels strange. Yet satisfying. Search. How do I search them? There's nothing on them to even search. Does it make them faint? Or is it automatically a Nuzlocke? They still faint.
So, you are a warrior.
And you can still use them, but... We could impose our own Nuzlocke rules on it, but I think that would be seriously difficult. Like, we just have to pick one enemy from each area to catch, and then if that one dies, we can't use it anymore. Ooh. I don't know if anyone's ever attempted even a Nuzlocke using that mod. Very few people have even made videos of it. I saw at least a couple people who did, though. Stop blocking me. There you go. The way their head just falls off. Drop kick a skeleton! Now I have lived. I'm surprised Kyle Crane has no dialogue for any of this. Like, that he's not just like constantly shocked by the fact that he's in this video game world fighting skeletons and demons. It's kind of like that thing people point out about Fallout 4. Just that the character you play as in that is never surprised by seeing the giant green Hulk beast running around or anything like that. Well, that's true. We could make our own Nuzlocke rules. It's totally Uncharted. We should think about that. Then we could do two per location. That would work. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, the mod was never updated to work with enemies from the DLC because of programming limitations. So we'd have to... we'd probably have to scrap that by the time we reached the DLC, or just not play it, I guess, but... But yeah, we can do whatever we want with it. We are defining the rules of this. Okay, a couple of enemies. Down here, huh? Whoa! I thought this was just like a giant health potion. It's just a big old jar. Hey, you! Eat this! Oh! Okay. Wow. I don't know what I expected. And I don't know why it wasn't that. Love that as a lore idea, though. The first normal playthrough is just a Pokemon game with a dark atmosphere, but that's it. And then the second one is our Pokemon protagonist in a full-blown massacre. When it's insane to start killing Pokemon. Right, yeah. Yeah, and the DLC can be a genocide run. Honestly, that sounds like a great idea, where it's just like, we play up until the DLC, and then just, patch it to allow us to attack the Pokemon. I mean, the Pokemon, the enemies. And then just, start slaughtering all of them. Because, the thing is, with that mod, it removes your ability to fight, so you're forced to use only the enemies you capture. But there are people who have made patches that let you still fight. So we can add that in at the DLC. We can still fight alongside the Pokemon we have, but then we can also join them in the battle. Drink up! Uh oh, Lightning Skeleton. Hellraid, level up! Why can't I attack? Help! I'm stuck! Oh, it must be broken. I'm used to you still being able to use them while they're broken. That really messed me up. Yeah, we'll have to wait a while, but it'll give me some time to, figure stuff out. And then, establish all the great lore. Neat. Ah, you know what? I don't have my ninja grappling hook. Oh well. That's the way it's gotta be. Empty. Nice. Look at you being all tough. Whoa! Giving me that fake dead ghoul thing there. Hell splitter. Okay. Alright, give me a sec. 906 power. That's pretty good. By comparison. I mean, even by normal game standards, it's pretty tough. I forgot I could do that. It's a heavy weapon. That explains the amount of damage, but... And, a heavy weapon might actually be pretty decent for Hellraid compared to the main game, because you're not getting swarmed as much. As much, but there are still probably going to be a couple times. Probably later, anyway. I know how most Souls games have the leveling system with a bunch of stats. Sekiro's leveling is not like that. Don't know if the term linear is accurate. Not sure. I hadn't thought about that, how its leveling would work. Ah. You. Ooh, it's shaking. Shaking like a leaf. Back off. I just gotta find the Clavis Stone. What the heck is a Clavis Stone?
You're not alone. She knows.
She knows? The mother? We haven't killed her yet, so... collect a special item. When you collect a certain amount, you can upgrade your health, and it's unlimited. Once you get them all, you don't get any more. New game plus. I see. Torturer. Did he just, like, clap his fists together? Wow. This guy's a beast. And he hits hard. Very hard. I might need something faster for this. It seems to be doing about as good of damage, despite the fact that speed is way better. Yeah. Yeah, this guy totally belongs in Dark Souls right here. Help, I'm stuck! I'm stuck! I was backing up into the freaking table. Can't get me up here, can ya, big boy? Crack this thing open. Okay, here's my exploding barrel. I probably should have used that against him there. Whoops. What? Shouldn't this have opened? It's usually how it works, right? Is there a way to throw that far enough away so that I don't get owned by it? Open this. Does that mean I'm missing one? Or more? Curiosidad. Ooh, a Resident Evil fan. Or Biohazard. Same thing, I guess. Oh, I had to kill all the zombies? I didn't know it worked like that. Oh well. What's done is done. Ooh, there it is. Hey, I don't have it yet. There.
Taking the first Clavis stone.
Clavis.
The treasure is yours.
Woo! We're a third of the way there! Third of the way there! Third of the way there! What the heck? Didn't even play the sound effect. Healing potion. Sweet. I needed that. I had a heaping amount of zero prior. Uh-oh. Lightning zombie. Yeah, You do look just like a zombie right now. It was punny. I like punny. Violin? Like violin. And bio is in biohazard. Cool. Okay, Hellraid. I am currently a wanderer. I roam around. Let's see, I get a gut splitter. And okay, I get the raider armor. Whatever that is.
You feel it? Anger fills the air.
Mm-hmm. You see, they're trying to give us one of those filler precursors to the next villain here.
Many souls.
Okay. Trust me, I'm very good at the stopping of taking souls. I will never fail catastrophically at that. I'm hoping this is also one of those things where it's filler, but then they add like a super OP like transformation that they just conveniently lose right at the end. I know that's probably not gonna happen, but it'd be nice. I wonder why it takes so long to do this. I guess it's so you'll have to kill everything, so that they don't kill you while you're trying to tear it down. They're below me. Oh, wait, they're here. Shocking. Still hear the echoes of their screams. So it seems like I'm supposed to go down, right? Because there's enemies down there. How do I get down? Tiny chest. Whoa! Uh-oh! Don't know how that happened. Don't care. I see a zombie right there. Now, if he could get up, you'd think he would have done it by now? But if he can't get up, then how do I get down? Why must this be so confusing? Like, what's probably stopping me is that there's one dude below us. Because we have to kill everything. Are they not supposed to be down there? Did it bug out or something? No, that can't be. Medieval fantasy things are always confusing. Yeah, pretty much. But this especially, I mean, what's confusing me is there's only one enemy down there. Like, how messed up would that be if they're like, hey, we put one enemy down in this little underground area that's really hard to get to. Got him. Yeah, that'll show him. Oh no, it's above me. I'm stupid. Forgive. There, now let me out of here. Okay, those two are definitely below, but I think they just spawned. Ah! Ah, oh, they were up here. I thought they were below me. I don't know why I thought that. Ah! I gotta learn to read the legend stuff here better. Oh well, eh. I could have sworn I saw one below. Why did I think that? Unless there was one below and I just didn't realize it. Nah, that can't be. That everyone? Nope. What? Maybe? No, there's more. Hey there, Skelly. You came unarmed. Yeah. Oh, it's broken. I mean, unlike the other one, I can still use it? Huh? Why aren't you dead? This thing's supposed to be strong. Oh yeah, it was just broken before. Not in the sense that it was actually broken, but that I just couldn't use it? Weird. This guy. This is a slow weapon with like 900 damage. Why are you not dying from it? Okay, there. Like, heavy weapons especially should be good against a skeleton, because they'll just knock him apart. That's more like it. First Red Dead also had a zombie DLC? It did, I remember. They're gonna let me out of here. Still got this. Man, I've only got a bunch of lousy foul blades. Okay, there we go. Much better. Head smasher, ruffian sword. I like. Yeah, you're probably right. It's probably blunt weapons that would be better. I know it's bladed, so a bladed thing wouldn't be good against a skeleton, but it's so heavy that it would still knock him over about as good as a blunt weapon would. Just realistically speaking. Nice. I am now a looter. Looters and polluters. Blew up the zombies' heads on contact. What's a stamina potion do? I don't know, it's not even in my inventory. So you got me. Find a unicorn. Use a rainbow trail. That sounds incredible. Just puppy guard them. Oh, there's just one. Sure. Oh. I love the little confident strut the skeletons have. What, is this an acid pit? Can I, like, hit a button and just drop him in? I'd like that. The zombie outbreak was caused by an uncovered Aztec artifact. Classic. Put it back, and then years later, you die, and then the crazy hillbilly friend steals it again, causing you to rise as a zombie. Jeez. Gut spiller. That's not edgy. And that armor does wonders. Tiny chest. What now? Opened up into here. Good.
The second stone grows nearer.
Oh, you were buried with a flask of holy water in your pocket. So you're still sapient, but still a zombie. Cool. Ooh, he's got a shield! No fair, wish I had a shield. I wonder if I drop kicked it, what it would do. Let's find out! Nothing. That's what. Ow. That did the job. Ha! Yeah, it really makes them immune. I was hoping they would still fly back anyway, but it does seem to knock the shield away. Wow, I didn't realize my health was so low. You only have 3 lives in the Hellraid raid mode. Well, I'm not in the Hellraid raid mode, so we're fine. Where'd that put me? Yeah, just back here. In fact, everything I killed is still dead. I am down nothing for that defeat. Ow, 4 damage, but still knocked me flat. Haha! I'll take that. Wish. It's time for the arm cruncher. Raid. I ain't got that right, 3 a.m. Fire does tend to be hot. I don't know why I keep forgetting that. What's this still doing here? Oh no, that's not good. Oh no, it's just because there's somebody up above trolling me again. Boom! Effective! Don't knock me down the stairs! Hey. You wondering if I can say the A word that means butt and donkey? I prefer not to, honestly. It's just like one tier above my usual comfortability. Comfortability, yeah. My usual comfortable level, so to speak. Ah! It's over, skeleton. Yeah, the skeleton knight had the high ground. He had me for a sec there. Not as much as the other guy who did successfully kill me. Oh, they're crawling up. Ah, I just barely missed that. Uh-oh, this is bad. Yeah, I don't even remember much of that Zombie Night video anymore. I'll see it again someday. Drop kick a skeleton! Wait, I still got a zoom in of his bones, but I can always see his bones. See, I don't need an x-ray shot of his bones. Ow. He took me out midair with that. This one's bulky. There we go. Uh-oh, they're coming. I did it. Ow! Well, fireball to the face. I guess that works. Blunt! Yeah, blunt definitely does the trick. D&D rules apply. Whoa, he's going nuts with those fireballs. Ah! Excuse me, she is. Is that all you got? Apparently. if he gets struck for playing that song on stream? Probably. Well, I mean, if it's a game soundtrack, less likely. Yeah, Undead Nightmare, Bad Voodoo. I'll definitely have to check that out. Let me see. I spelled nightmare with a K. Why are the comments turned off on it? I'll just let this play while I kill these guys. Fits pretty well. And second Clavis stone down. Yeah, I don't know why I'm saying it like that.
Good, just one more.
And then I shall be free.
I don't trust you, Lucius. Pretty sure you're the devil. If your name sounds very similar to Lucifer. You know, the devil. Oh, there's 992,000 has comments. Makes sense. It's just the auto uploaded one doesn't. Uh-oh. Fire. Oh, that went a lot further than I was expecting. Oh, wow, I can actually lure them away with that. That's neat. Get zapped! It's ninja stealth time. Uh-oh. Ah! Well, ninja stealth time is over. She's so stupid! Yeah, she somehow was able to triangulate my, trajectory. I don't know, I guess she just had to turn around and look at me, but still. Sunny V2? I think I heard someone mention them. Yeah, that's right. I've been recommended their videos a lot. And I know I've seen some of them too, pretty sure. Yeah, I did. I saw the one about Gordon Ramsay and the vegan teacher. That was a good video. I'm not subbed to them, but maybe I should be. Oh no, the comments were turned off because there are minors. I think I identified as such. Why do you remember that? Who knows? Sometimes you just remember things. The Fine Bros one is pretty brutal. I imagine. They got dunked on pretty bad. For their React World thing. I remember. I was there front and center for that one. I was never subbed to them, but I did watch their content on occasion, if any of them happened to interest me.
In the treasure vault lies more than mere riches. Find me.
It lies the cure to the zombie virus.
That range. Boom. Ah. Whip. Not what I expected, but I'll take it. Ha, fire Skelly. You're fired.
Ooh, big guy's ready to go. Might want to swap out for this one.
This dude was a boss earlier, now he's just a regular enemy. It is like Dark Souls.
Get the fire one out of here. I leveled up again.
Enough. Is that guy still alive? Oh, he was for a second, and then he just fell over.
No! Oh, it actually interrupts you. I thought I could just power through it. It's not.
No more.
There.
Below me, right? Ow. Should have expected that.
Oh snap. I'm stuck.
It gets the job done, even if very slowly.
So slow. Come on, Crane, you can swing faster than that.
Still got a couple good things in here, maybe. Wait, can I repair them? Because if I can repair them, I should just do that. Nah, it doesn't look like it. Which is weird, there's still the repair button. But yeah, no repairs left, In which case, I should just dismantle them? Yeah, just dismantle them. Get a little bit of coin out of it. Just swap in my Grim Scepters. Nobody sneak attack me. Yeah, of course, a little bit left. Puppy guard. Now they're not coming in through there. All right, come on down. There's only a couple of you. There he is. There you have it. Stamina potion, again, still haven't seen that in my inventory at any point. Ah, yes. It's above me. And why shouldn't it be, right? Hello. Oh, that was easy. Ooh, dummies. Treasure. Explosive. I could use that. Ooh, this is it. See? That was easy. And, Mjolnir. Well, my inventory's full, but, I would like that. So allow me to just, if there's anything broken in here, I should scrap that. Is Crane worthy? Well, he just picked it up, so it would seem as though he is. Yeah, just in time for God of War Ragnarok. You got Mjolnir now. Let's go. Send him in. Is it a dragon? Oh, place them. Beh. This blows up on me. I know you're gonna send something in here to fight me. Look at this place. And Cordova Stone's done. He was a key all along. The dragon. Nah, just more skeletons. Boom. Oh man, Mjolnir is doing work. Boom. Oh, plasma. Why do we have plasma throwers? Don't you run from me. I am the mighty Thor! We've killed the mighty Thor, so of course we're worthy. I mean, canonically, we did. Actually, that is... I don't think... That hasn't happened yet. Oh, well. This just proved that even before we faced Thor, we were worthy. That's definitely one of those filler things. Anyone wonder if Kratos is gonna cut off Thor's arm holding Mjolnir and then holding the arm he smashes Thor's head with the hammer? It would be awesome. But technically he probably doesn't even have to do that because it doesn't have the worthiness restriction. You just need to be strong enough to wield it. And Kratos should definitely be strong enough to lift it. Considering that he can wield the Leviathan axe, which is equal in power to it. It would still be cool for him to do it though. And although we've killed two Thors already, and we're likely going to kill another as Kratos. Right. Have we killed two already? I know the one. Can't think what the other one is. Crane and Jazz teamed up and beat the zombie Thor here, but... Oh yeah, you're right! The first boss from Salton Sanctuary, Wet Thor. That's interesting. Thor has shown up as a zombie twice. I guess that just ties them together. Man, I don't want to lose Mjolnir. Or Mjolnir, I think was how Herman told us to pronounce it, right? Something like that. But no joke, this thing is strong. I thought it was going to be weak and then I'd have to take back the joke of it being Mjolnir, but no, this is Mjolnir. Look at it. Nice. It was just one-shotting all the basic zombies, man. And by that, I mean skeletons. Is that all you have? Send me your best fighters! Ah, you made me drop it, you jerk! The runners make using that infeasible. Sadly. Anyway, what were we saying? Compared to the original games, is it less gory? Probably. I've heard people say that it is. It's still gory, I remember that, but... I've heard some people say it's probably less gory just because, Kratos is holding back in this game compared to the originals. Well, no, Fetus didn't kill Thor. Captain Kitchen killed him. But Kratos and Crane did as well. Unless we presume that Fetus fought Thor at some point on the island, but that would just mean another person to add to the list. We can assume that maybe they threw hands at some point. Oh my gosh, through the fire and flames over here. Hellraid level up, let's go. I do have to wonder, what in the world would Thor have even been doing there? I guess that means that Fetus somehow convinced Thor to join his religion. Very interesting. Yeah, Salton Sanctuary was a direct sequel to Demon's Souls. And a prequel to Dead Rising, because why not? Well, Dead Rising 2, anyway. And Dead Rising 1 by that stretch, too. Ah, busted, okay. Got one more. Man, I just want to use the gauntlets this guy's got on. That's what I want. I think there's chains wrapped around his arms now that I look at it. I don't know. Still want him, though. Just walking up to the Avengers and going, Mufasa, wearing a hat that makes him smile. Man, I want to see some art of that. The Minotaur! Uh-oh. Ah! The echo is dramatic. Ow! Ugh, jeez-em. Oh no! I can't fight him and all of these guys at the same time! Eh. Uh-oh. I was trying to do a side jump and then jump forward instead. And they replaced it with... yeah, a zombie. He's not really a minotaur. I don't know why they're calling him one. He's a dude in stockades. Oh, well, actually, no, he is a minotaur. He's just in stockades. That's cool. Dude, look at that. Ow. But what about Greek mythology, people? Ah. Did he get... how'd he get behind me? I'm dead, but... just, it'll take a sec. Man, if I had Mjolnir right now. Oh yeah, you just meant the Minotaur. I see. Yeah, speaking of it, Minotaur shows up. I gotcha. Which ones are these? I'm gonna smoke bomb? That's pretty ninja-like. Ow. Oh, that's my stamina potion. Sweet. Not sure what that achieved. Oh, no wonder it wasn't in my inventory, because I had it equipped. Explains a lot. Lousy lightning skeleton, get wrecked! I wonder if there's ever been any lore in any universe where a ninja fought a minotaur. I don't know, but, well, there is now. That's just an arm over there. Okay, just you and me now, Minnie. The trick would be to get him to run into these spikes. That's how it usually works. Actually, I hear somebody alive. Way over here. Enough! Right here. Right here. Oh no, more spawned in! This is ridiculous! Do they just keep spawning until I kill him? Because that's that would be unfortunate. Don't know if that's gonna even happen. I mean, I haven't really been trying that hard to kill him just because I thought I could kill everybody else first. A crazy battle of attrition. No, 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 no. That's close. No. And the ones that just sit back and camp you are so annoying, it's not even funny. Anyway, anyone say anything interesting? Is it wrong to pick up girls in a dungeon? I've heard of it, didn't see it. Not a ninja, but his fighting style is pretty close, and there's a pretty strong minotaur he fights. Huh. That might be as close as we're gonna get, other than, well, this game. Ah, busted. Shoot. Everything I've got is broken except the axe. And the axe sucks. No point in even trying. There's still more. Yeah, it just spawns more of them until he's dead. I think that is bad design. That is a terrible design decision, in my opinion. Like, that's just annoying. I hate that. When you're fighting a boss and they just think it's a fun, cool idea to just spawn in a bunch of annoying little enemies to distract you while you're trying to fight them. It's not my idea of a good time. And yay, he got his health back, but all my weapons are still destroyed. Also fair game design. Oh well, what are you gonna do? I still got a couple good ones. Let me just equip a potion of power. Maybe that'll even the odds. Weird looking. Die! Got him! Don Machi. Got it. I think I want those explosive flasks now. Thank you. There we go. That did it. Oh no! The skeleton survived it! Ah, that sucks! Okay. As long as the Minotaur is still dead, it doesn't really bother me. To obtain battle mallet. Does that mean I can just spawn it whenever I want, or how does it work? And there. Are you not entertained? Good. Back to hell. Back to the hell again.
Bet mem netsa.
Meh. Well, here's our portal. It's blue this time. That means it's good. It's a good portal. Find the cell. Hellraid imprisoned.
Others came before you to challenge a knot.
A knot. And they said battle mallet is right there. I'm still four levels away from unlocking that, apparently.
They did not have your skills.
All players required. I'm the only one here. Also, what's just this, like, currency that I'm grabbing? Is it, like, a store? That would be cool. There's one above. How is there one above? Is that his foot? Whoops. A little too high. There we go. Got him. What now? Find the cell. This entire DLC of the big arena battle is just one part of it. Just one part, I assume. Man, I wish I had my grappling hook. Am I supposed to do some parkour? I mean, this beam definitely doesn't reach anything.
Look up. Perhaps you can walk over those wooden beams.
I was thinking that, but there's no way. They can't reach him. I don't have my grappling hook. Ah, I see. Got the usual dying light guide. I'll be fine.
Wait, a chamber should be hidden here somewhere.
A chamber?
You might spot some sign of it.
Here it is. Ha ha. Still have no idea what this stuff is that I've been grabbing. Attack from the left for once, jeez. Ever talked about the banana melon salesman you once encountered? I don't think you've mentioned that. I think I would remember it. There you go, buddy.
They set a trap.
A trap?
They didn't think they would fall into it themselves.
Ho ho ho. Man, I want to fix that friggin' whoop. Battle mallet. What even is a banana melon salesman? Just what I needed. Always gotta watch out for if they have any grim scepters. Or a decently powerful limb cutter. That's good too. Generic Watto type dude, something Just the melons and stuff. You asked if you wanted them, you said no, he exclaimed. Melons are a substitute for bananas. I don't think that's true. Yeah, like, is there anything that a melon can be good for that would replace a banana? I don't think so. I mean, that would leave an impression on me, too. I mean, the main reason you want to eat bananas is potassium. And I don't believe melons have potassium. Very close. Ha! Hellraid up. Let's go. Sprays a bunch of potassium into it. he put supplements in there. Ow. Like Willy Wonka with the infinite candy flavors, but he has melons. I can get behind that. I don't know if this guy's supposed to be behind these bars, but he is. Makes it a little hard to kill him, wouldn't you say? Oh yeah, okay, if he can hit me, then I should be able to hit him. That's my thought process. Although I can't get to his face because I can't get close enough. And they just bounce off these bars. Oh, there, I got him. Nice. Wait, what's keeping this shut? Oh, was there supposed to be like a lever or something? Oh, wait, there's stairs. And there is a lever. Here it is. Oh, shoot, they got me. Ah! Did that reset the lever? You're kidding me. It had like 1 second left. Jeez! Ghost face. Hello. Did the stream just die? I think it's just you. I don't think we're experiencing any issues. Hello again, Ghostface. What's that? Melons are, in fact, the ultimate wonder fruit. I think I lost one of my headphones, but otherwise I'm doing fine. A chapel?
I cannot see the entrance. Someone must have hidden it well.
Yeah, someone must have hidden it well. Hehe. Uh-oh. Ha-ha! Are you kidding me? Again with the... Okay, no, I got it. I was like, if it did that to me again, where it was like 1 second too slow. But it's fine. Favorite scary movie? Good question. I don't watch too many scary movies. So it's hard for me to exactly pick one off the top of my head. Oh, I know. Tremors. That's my favorite scary movie. Like, in terms of Tremors was one of those movies that I watched a lot when I was younger. And it's really good. It's probably not one that people usually think of in terms of their favorite scary movie, but it's mine. The Kill of the First Friday the 13th? It's not Jason Voorhees, I'll tell you that. It's his mother, Pamela Voorhees. And I've got a little better on the other headphone. I'm surprised they've lasted this long, because I forgot to charge them. And I started charging them like 10 minutes before we started. And they've actually lasted me quite a while, all things considered. If you ever encounter anything Melon-related in our lore, I think you want to see him become a canon character. Oh yeah, for sure. The what? Freddy Krueger, maybe? there's a lot of people who could probably fit the bill for that description. I think he goes for babysitters, right? Usually? Don't get this movie trivia question right. Okay. Fair enough. I'm gonna have to try to dig back into my history of watching James A. Janisse over here.
God,
sounds like something Freddy Krueger would say right there. What you just said.
Do not let them lay hands on you.
Do not let them lay hands on you.
Too late. What do I do? I'm glad they incorporated a little bit of parkour into this. Outside the front door, come look. No. Don't even play at that. Exactly, doors are not a specialty. Come out there. No thanks. I'm in the middle of something here, can't you see? These ones are tough. Which is why they must be eliminated. I agree. Hey, there he is. Would you look at that?
I have waited years for this.
Hi, Lucius.
Destroy the crystals.
Yeah, you wear a black suit with the scream face on. Mm-hmm. So yeah, just ghost face. Haven't seen the movie Scream, but yeah. We could just kill you instead, but nah, I'll destroy the crystals. Why not? What do I have to lose? Binding crystal, it's a boss. It's in there. Ghostface for Halloween. Sweet. It's one of those bots like the DR1 we used to get. Feels like it. Just some light roleplay. That's true, it did get Senator Armstrong. Oh, they're defending it! Of course they are. It's a fool to think I could attack it without anybody going after me. Never stood a chance. Yeah, let's get smashing. Did it recover some of its health? That'd be strange. Let's stay tucked back here. They'll have a harder time hitting me. Oh, now I have to like hold F on that, don't I? Oh, that'll be a little harder. Before anyone else shows up. It's too late, they're already coming. Did it. In the basement. Destroy bindings. Well, I already did that. Basements are fun. Nice place to put people in. Oh, most deaf. Inactive. Yet I can open it. Be ready. How convenient that they just left you access to these. Yikes. Got an RTX. No. Hey, sweet. Got a PS5. Huh. I also have a PS5. drop on the chandelier and just send it crashing down. That'd be neat. Smash it to bits before they get to me. It's working. Get back here, Flamer. Busted. Shoot. Not you. Oh, no, all my good stuff is missing. Guess might as well give context of the shrimp thing that kidnaps field members of its own species and puts 10 of them in a cave. You can imagine the rest. I know the PS5 has ray tracing built in. I did know that. It was built to be able to handle ray tracing. Alright, we're in good shape now. Bolster our power for a little bit. Play Minecraft on it because the RTX. Sounds like fun. I usually play Minecraft on PC myself whenever I do play it occasionally. And this power potion, it helps. And I'm running out of weapons so fast. Oh well, I freed you, now take me back to Earth. And then, oh no, he betrayed us and he's gonna take us further down into hell. My PC specs? Not sure. I don't know them off the top of my head, but they're pretty decent. I mean, by today's standards, they're a little less than that, because this PC is like 3 years old.
We must stop her before she attacks. I was unable to do so myself, but you heard my call. I shall support you with my wisdom and magic, and you shall make use of your strength and dexterity. Together, we have a sliver of a chance.
I don't have a GTX, sadly.
This temple is full of magic. I sense 3 powerful spells. I am not the only one who has been imprisoned here all these years. We need to find out what are not wants.
But to circle back to what Freeclips was saying about the shrimp thing, that's weird. They just kidnapped them, put them in a cave, and then, there goes my other headphone. Uncover the temple's secrets. You know what? This feels like a pretty good stopping point. I mean, I think it's dropped us off at a hub environment, so that's actually probably a pretty good time for this, right? Seems like it. Like, now I've got these new weapons in here. Which is cool. Yeah, the armory. Okay. Feel free to describe the really messed up part. Works for me. There's also a bounty? Bounty selector. Worthy of Surtur, as in the Ragnarok kind? Thick head hunter, smashed heads. D capital punishment. 3 heads with 1 swing. That gives me the blueprint for the ruffian sword. This is really neat. Head smasher, grim scepter one. Ain't the sharpest in the shed. Alright, give me that one. crippled enemies. How do I cripple enemies? After a totally 100% consensual baby-making ritual with each of them, there's a species for whatever insane reason nature allowed this to happen, are not allowed to be born. Instead, they have to eat their way out. It's the first moment of their lives. That happens surprisingly often. It's strange. Okay, there's raid mode. This is a story quest. Mm-hmm. No free spot. Of course not. No, he's just describing something that that shrimp do. He's fine. Actually, I should probably keep that. Don't I want that? I'm pretty much good on stuff. Let me just drop that instead. Yeah. And a head smasher. I feel like there must be a store of some kind. Oh, well, you know what? This is at the very beginning of the game. Interesting. Only now this stuff is here. Oh well. Fortunately, I did not invent that. I would like to take credit for it, but no. Some people do have serious issues. That much is true. Oh gosh, look, Post Malone himself with no profile picture. The same thing that Ghostface has. Isn't that interesting? Not every day you run into Post Malone's official YouTube channel. Yeah, what a neat coincidence. Stuff happens, man. It tends to. Oh well, we've freed this guy. Turns out he's not betraying us and just is going to help us with his magic, so that's cool. Maybe at some point down the line he'll betray us, but who knows. And it's just under 2 hours. I guess we can just chill for a little bit as we wrap up. And then next time, whenever we stream next, I don't know if they're going to have me immediately coming in and starting off my schedule. I have orientation on Saturday, so they're probably going to want me to start pretty soon. I'll just have to keep you guys informed. Is he a Cyclops? I don't know. It looks like he either didn't have eyes, or like they were covered with like bushy eyebrows. It's weird. Don't know. But hey, I think that's a good innings for one stream. Just unlock ourselves what essentially is the hub environment, I suppose. And the next time we'll continue along with the story quest. Which I think is just when we officially start the actual meat of things there, right? Just TDG? The heck is TDG? Isn't that interesting? When I click on it, it leads to official Post Malone channel. Only now it says just TDG instead. And it's all the same videos. Curious. Post Malone going undercover. But way it's looking now is that next stream will be tomorrow, tomorrow night. And I know Freak Clips won't be able to be there, sadly, because, you know, time zones and all that. But we're pretty much going to be settling in to finish Pokemon Colosseum. And that'll be great. Would have liked to do it on Saturday like normal, but you know how it is. Love Zone. I don't know what Just TDG is. Is that another channel that I'm not familiar with? Yeah, it is. They have 4.39 thousand subscribers and they have been playing Dying Light. Neato. What time would it be? I think we were, set for it to be 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time is when we'll be, starting it. Maybe we'll get lucky and wake up at 4 a.m.? Yeah, I wouldn't suggest it. Yeah, 6 p.m. California. You're correct. So, Dying Light's a depressing game. Oh, yeah. The canon ending is, quite sad. Oh, modders and stuff. That's what you meant? I'm not sure about that one. Then you can make it? Ah, sweet. That'll be fun. Because, usually whenever we do streams at different times, I'm never sure if people can show up, but... Anybody who can, I'd appreciate it. You get home in what would be 3 PST, you think. Right, right, cool. You'll have a few hours to get ready for it then. Martin's night hurts, makes you want to cry. Oh well, anyway, we've just gotten started with the Hellraid. Kyle Crane's non-canon adventures through Hades over here have gone decently well. We have found out that we are worthy of wielding Mjolnir, just officially. I'm not sure what lore-wise would take it away from us, but we'll think of that later. There's a lot we could do for the next thumbnail, but I think we agree to do the filler joke. I agree. There's also the potential of having Crane wielding Mjolnir next. maybe we can do both. Because as of now, I have not gotten any, like, cool suit of armor, because I think you only unlock that near the end. Yeah, I'm right here. I'm still 4 levels off from getting the Raider armor. Lightsaber in one hand, Mjolnir in the other. Oh, that would be awesome. If I can find a way to make that happen, I'll do that. It is surprisingly hard to find good imagery of ninjas dual-wielding swords. I swear, it took me forever to find anything that I could even remotely use for that last thumbnail for the following. Using Mjolnir is like force lightning. Yeah, it's like cheating. Normally it's a dark side move, but now he can use it. Crane, if you become a Sith Lord? No, I'm just worthy. Psh! Just zaps him. That'd be awesome. It's a shame this is non-canon. You hats me? Freak Eclipse, how could you say that? I am wounded, good sir. Ouch. What a betrayal. A backstab. An absolute 180. I'm stunned. Well, on that note, I don't think there's much else we can say. So, thanks everybody. This was a good stream. I had fun. Hope you did too. And I hope to catch you next time. Please don't get confused by this person if they show up in the stream when it'll be 4 a.m. for me. Don't worry. Remember, you're a mod. They're not. There's no way I could get them mixed up. It would be impossible. Because your name is Blue and you have a wrench. Oh well, like I was saying, thanks, was a good time in hell. About as good of a time in hell as you would expect. 3 a.m. Yeah. Wow. Very direct approach there, Freak Eclipse. I'm flattered and all, but I think I have to think about it some more. I won't forget. My brain is used to seeing your name with the blue wrench on it. There's no way I'll forget, but I appreciate the concern. Anyway. Thanks everyone. Tune me in again. I'll see you guys in the next live stream. Later.
Thanks, Dad.
And outro. Engage. It won't have the bananas because I swapped it.